Tēnā koutou katoa, welcome to the show. Happy Monday. Our first story is about a keen team of young baseball players who are serious about their commitment to the game.
So when the rules stopped them entering a national tournament, they wanted answers. Jill went to find out why the team couldn't get their case past first base.
These Canterbury players have got skill. They've got team spirit.
Nice catch, Rachel.
And dedication.
Do you play any other sports?
Yeah, I play six.
Do you have a favourite?
Baseball.
But here in Christchurch, there's something they haven't got.
At the moment, we've got nobody to play.
Not for miles, in any direction. Which is why a tournament in Nelson was a big hit with the team. It could be game on. Described as a great platform to participate and compete, the chance to be national age group champions.
Got really excited, yeah, basically.
Just give us opportunity to play because we didn't really have any other teams to play against.
Couldn't believe it. I thought, this is awesome. We get to take our team up to Nelson. We have a whole weekend up there. We stay locally. We've done it before, you know, for previous tournaments.
Good pitches now.
But talk about a curveball.
As parents, you all got an email saying, we can't go because not enough of our players were registered last year. As we're not a playing team, a lot of the parents didn't see a point in getting registered.
The last chance to register was end November. Still, it was only the start of February, and the tournament wasn't till April, so...
We offered to register them there and then, and they said no.
It was Canterbury Baseball that were keen to enter a team, but they accepted Baseball New Zealand's rule that late registrations weren't possible. Not the parents, though.
I'm sure you said, well, can you explain why that's so important?
Yes, I did, yeah.
What did they come back with?
Baseball New Zealand had never applied to me. I emailed Baseball New Zealand, Oceania Baseball, my local MP, Minister for Sport, and I CC'd Baseball New Zealand into all those emails, and I've had no response apart from yours. So thank you. Somebody's listening.
As you can see, Leslie's determined to bat for her son's team.
There's COVID in my family and I'm not going to stay home. I'm going to come out and make my point known that what's happening is wrong.
She hoped Baseball New Zealand would step up to the plate.
It's about children. Children need to go and play. They're keen, they want to play. Let them play.
Instead, these players are down that they're out.
It's kind of annoying.
It was really annoying because baseball's not really, really big here. And like it's kind of just more of an opportunity for us to get like seen and get more playing time. And
Baseball New Zealand says rules are rules.
Other regions, they abide by the process. They have registered members. They register at the start of the season, just like everybody else has to.
It's not the first case of late registration preventing a team from taking part, and it's definitely not the most famous. Remember this?
Their dream was to compete in the Olympics. But they chose a sport they knew nothing about.
In the movie, they had to beat the odds. In real life, they had to beat the rules as well as the odds. At first, they were told late registration barred them from taking part.
But in their case, the Olympic Committee reversed its decision on appeal. So the team famously got to compete.
Even the IOC, the International Olympic Committee, can change its mind. And it does so just about every year.
Sport policy expert Mike Sam loves a good old movie, especially one that makes a fair old point.
For every sport, I think the two main objectives are getting more people to play more and getting more people to play better. That's what they should be trying to do.
He's baffled by Baseball New Zealand's decision.
Thinking about why registrations need to occur by a certain date, and I really can't think of a reason.
So we tried again to get one.
What was the harm in letting them register that team to play in the tournament?
The harm comes that it's unfair to those players that have played the whole season. National tournaments are put together as a pinnacle event.
Registration does show commitment, but these Canterbury players have shown it in other ways. Most had played for years. Several have trialled for national teams. Four were registered this year, five in previous years. Just three were new registrations.
There we go.
And remember, the lack of registration was because they had no teams to play against, yet they still practice twice a week. It's what they live for.
I kind of grew up with it. My great-grandpa played baseball when he was in Canada, and so did my grandpa.
I was born in Ohio, in America, so yeah, I always played it.
Started in Japan, came back, and found this club.
The other players are passionate too, and the parents, but they weren't prepared to front.
Parents are scared that the fact they stand up for what they believe in will affect, you know, their child's future in baseball.
We've seen the letters of support.
Everybody was really disappointed. Some people got quite angry.
We would probably say that that's unfounded from a Baseball New Zealand perspective. We work closely with our regional associations and our clubs. We understand that the communication may have degraded a little bit, but we know that our club and our regional association have provided the parent group with sufficient information.
Sadly, the team haven't even got to first base on this one. The tournament for under-16s was cancelled due to, you got it, not enough teams to compete.
We're never going to grow the sport if you don't get children playing.
So game over for now. But they proved they had balls. And they're getting to talk with Baseball New Zealand through mediation. And their stand might help down the line.
It might not make a difference immediately, but the boys who spoke up and the parents who spoke up, I'm almost certain it will make a difference in the future.
Oh, I reckon just let the kids play. No, get them out on the diamond.
Don't let them play. Why do we want the kids to play? It's going to be bad for their health.
Don't
let them
to him.
Play. Make sure they're registered.